not to support our church. For a very long time here, it is a tradition in our church, especially the Catholic Church. The concept of self-supporting church is gradually taking shape because we have just made very slight transition from the missionary church to the local church. In our church, we had, as Father Isaac was explaining, in the Catholic Church, it's like when we are educated, development is highly connected. You cannot just preach the word of God and leave people in poverty. The first year, Jesus was preaching and he said, you give them food. You think, you pray, you have something is needed. So the faith, the missionary who came in here, they had support from their own countries and they were able to provide the necessary support that we have. And somehow, our faithful in our church still carry very strong belief that the Catholic Church is very rich and they have money in Rome that they can take any time and do development with it. And I was making a joke, I studied in Rome for 5-6 years. And I kept moving around the Vatican, every corner to see where this money is, I can collect. Well, eh? Nothing. So it's not like that. The money is the best food. So we have introduced what we call Hume koda-bee, not Arambe. It's almost the same Hume koda-bee. That means people put their hands together, the power of uniting in our hands, we can do greater things. The power of uniting our mind, we can do greater things. So, humme koda pe na ye pe humme koda pera. Shikini udarani anso na kumbataye. So it helps, all those help us to move ahead. That's why we have this program here. And I had a lot of activities that I do. I was just telling the people, alone we have 52 priests. 8 of them are studying outside the country. 4 of them are working in the mission, or sisters of different groups who are actually particularly attached to us are 67. The catechists are over 622. The seminarians are 218. And the big number of them are already in the major seminary. And also, of course, the minor seminary we have 158. And all these are people that we must take care of them. Money does not come from anywhere, but we are the one to do what we can to support them. So when you are giving me gifts, you know that the money is not going for my private use, but it is for all our good. Of course, if you feed me well, then I can remain strong to serve you. Like now, the beautiful shoes I'm using, now my secretary, the secretary general of the Bishop's Conference, brought to me and they said, Bishop, you try. When I put my leg, it fit it. I don't know how you knew my number. Some people talk on my back anyway. So, and I'm okay now because I have beautiful shoes. But the one who does not say, oh, maybe the bishop bought it. Many of you are providing me with things that I have. So, this exercise is good. I don't want to take us long. You have to love it, let us take it. It's not only for the church, it's for all of us to come out of the poverty. Let us imagine ourselves, we are in a deep hole, all of us, to come out, not as individuals. We push somebody out, that person will go and bring the ladder and put down into the hole, all of us will come out. So we have to do it together. This is the exercise I have to appeal to all of us to use. And I'm happy that the governor is here, even the government. All of us unite, and then we do a particular project, and we do it. The Rwandans are doing it. A one full day, we are in a month, we have calculated the program. It is Nagoli that we are going to focus on it. All of us go to Nagoli to open the road and do what we can do there. And the same for Onapel, and so on. I think if we do this, we can change a lot of things. No money is going to come out and it will never be enough to solve all the needs we have. So we unite in this culture, many things will happen. And finally, last year, the money contributed in this kind of vocation was close to $5,000, and we have used it to build one house in the village house, and then also pay the school fees for our students in Uganda, the seminarians. So I will hope we have very serious people in this department. We have not created the department. Simon Sarwasi is the head of that department, and he's the secretary general. I think he's a brigadier, I don't know the title, but he's our Christian, not Father Joseph, but Joseph Sasa, is a secretary there. So we and other many members, we want you to get the accountability. Whatever money you give, the support you give, we must tell you in letter and the spirit and heart how we have used the resource you have given to us.